Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. We have another option for making amines, and it involves reducing amides. Across the very top of the screen is a reaction sequence. We have ammonia reacting with an acid chloride, followed by a reduction with lithium aluminum hydride. The product is a primary amine. Well, this is interesting. We made a primary amine, and the group on the nitrogen is equal to the R group from the acid chloride, as well as the CH2 from the carbonyl carbon. There's no reason why we couldn't extend this approach to secondary and tertiary amines too. Those are shown at the bottom of the slide. To the left, a primary amine plus an acid chloride makes an amide, reduced with LAH to make a secondary amine. Again, the new group on the nitrogen is the R group from our acid chloride plus a CH2, which comes from the carbonyl compound. Repeat this process again and you get a tertiary amine. This is great. One advantage to this method is that you avoid making imines and enamines. Imines and enamines are unstable to water, and sometimes they are difficult to prepare. In contrast, amides are easy to make. Acid chlorides are easy to make. We can make them from almost any carboxylic acid at the top of the screen and reacting it with thionyl chloride. Amides are very stable and easy to isolate. Okay, well, why would I ever use imines and enamines to make an amine? There is a reason. Let's say we have this primary amine, benzyl amine, and we want to make the amine to the left, the secondary amine. Using amides is so easy, but it won't work in this case. The problem is that the new group on the nitrogen does not have a CH2 group attached to the nitrogen. Instead, we have this branched carbon, a CH. You cannot introduce branched alkyl groups using the amide reduction method. That's okay, we can still react the primary amine with a ketone make an imine, and then reduce the imine with sodium borohydride in an alcohol solvent to make the desired secondary amine. The imine and enamine chemistry allow the introduction of branched alkyl groups into new amines. In conclusion, amides are very useful for making amines through reduction with lithium aluminum hydride. Although simple, the amide method cannot make branched alkyl amines.